Hello everyone and welcome to Era Tutorial. I'm Aarti Naik and today we are going to learn Class 8 Subject English Unit 3 3.4 Leisure. Leisure means free time, whichever free time you are getting in your life. You are doing the activity which you like, which you love to do. Okay, so in your leisure time you have to develop your hobbies, you have to spend some time with nature. Try to understand the nature, that all these things we are going to see in this poem. So before we start the poem, let us go through warming up, discuss in groups and share with one another. So this question, whatever points are given, you are going to discuss it in a groups and you are going to share it with one another. The daily routine of your mother and father on working days. So if they are working, might be 6 or 8 hours they are spending on their working places. So what is their daily routine is there, that you have to discuss. How your family relaxes on weekend. So how you are celebrating weekend, or what you are doing during the weekend, that you have to discuss. When you go for a picnic, what and how do you enjoy? Sometimes for weekends we used to go for picnic. And when we are going for the picnic, at that time how you are enjoying, that you discuss with your friends. Do you spend time admiring and thinking over the beauties of nature? Now elaborate your response. That means, are you admiring or thinking over the beauties of nature? That means, if the sky is clear blue, how it is beautiful. Sun, when sun rises, the color of sky changes. In nature, beautiful trees are there, birds are there, butterflies are there, so many flowers are there. So are you enjoying the beauty of the nature? When a poet or writer attempts to describe something in words so that it appeals to our five senses. That means, when any writer or poet is writing something, we started imagining. So if it is related to our sense organs, we started making imagination of it. It is related to sight, smell, hearing, touch, taste. Or he or she has used a device called imagiary. That means, with imagination we can think over it. For example, a host of golden daffodils. So here daffodils are of yellow color, but when we are during the sunlight, when we observe it, poet has compared it with golden color. So we can imagine it as a golden color. Or to a chasm deep and vast and wide. So it gives us the idea about the depth of the chasm. Okay, go through other poem in your textbook or other books and find out lines that contain imagiary. Write them down along with the name of the poem and line stanza number. Now prepare an acrostic. Now here to prepare an acrostic. Acrostic means you have to give full form of, or you have to give your own words for which begin with the given letter. For example, here we are making the acrostic of leisure. So when we are doing this activity, this word should be related to the word leisure. Okay. So first you can write down that lots of liveliness. For E, you can write down enjoy reading. That means here leisure means in your free time which activities you are doing. Okay. Then with I, interesting games you are playing. With S, you are sleeping sometime. With U, undertake or clean house. R, reading stories. E, exercise. So all these things are there that you are doing during your leisure time. You can make your own acrostic. Okay, let us start with the poem. Leisure. Leisure means a free time which we are getting in our routine and after completing our work, or sometimes in between we are getting some free time. That is called as a leisure. Let us start with the poem. This poem is written by William Henry Davis. Now, let us see the first stanza. What is the life if full of care? We have no time to stand and stare. Now, here poet is saying that do you can you imagine your full life with care only? That means all the time you are busy, you are not getting free time, and all the time you are with worries and stress only. Then in that case, how will be your life? And we have no time to stand and stare. That means no free time to stand and see the nature. No time to stand beneath the boughs. That means branches of a tree. That means if suppose in your life you are not getting any time to stand under the tree and stare as long as sheep and cows. That means in the open space when cows and sheep are grazing, at that time, if suppose you haven't seen that scenario, that means you haven't enjoyed anything from the nature. No time to see when woods we pass. That means if suppose we are passing through the forest and we don't have time to see the forest also, where squirrels hide their nuts in grass. Now, in forest you can see different types of animals are there, birds are there, insects are there. If suppose when you are passing through the forest and you don't have time to see all this, then your life is useless. No time to see in broad daylight streams full of stars. That means in broad daylight, if you see the streams, the water is sparkling like the stars, like skies at night. That means at night how sky is looking beautiful with the stars. Like that you can see streams are full of stars. But when? In a broad daylight. No time to turn at beauty's glance. That means if suppose any beautiful girl is there and if we don't have time to see that beautiful girl, then our life is useless. And watch her feet, how they can dance. That means how she is walking, how she is doing movement. If suppose that natural beauty, if you are unable to see, then what you did in your life. No time to wait till her mouth can enrich the smile her eyes begin. That means if suppose any beautiful girl is there, if she is smiling and you don't have time to see her smile, then also means you have done nothing in your life. A poor life this if. That means if whatever the poet has said, that means if suppose you are passing through the forest and you don't have time to see the forest, you are passing through a beautiful girl and you don't have time to look at her. If you don't have time to see the stream in broad daylight, then your life is very poor. Nothing you have gained from the life. So a poor life this if full of care. That means your life is useless if you are full of stress and worries. We have no time to stand and stare. So, if when we are full of worries, at that time we don't have time to stand and stare. So, here poet want to give us advice or message that we have to spend some time in nature. Because from nature we are learning so many things, and that is the best means with which we can relax our mind. So, we have to spend some time with the nature. And that is what poet want to give us the message. I hope that everyone might have understood the poem. If you have any queries, do write in comment box. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Share it, like it. Thank you.